Hello everyone and welcome to BlenderWorks. This will be the last session on the procedural texture node series, and in this session we will learn how to make a cloth procedural texture. So let's get started. So this is a piece of cloth, and if you look closely, the cloth has very fine threads which are basically straight lines in x and y axis. So this line can be formed by using wave texture in Blender. If we use two wave textures, one for each axis, and increase the scale of the wave to like 3 to 400 and rotate it, we will get these lines. So these threads are basically the bumps in our cloth, and for color we will use the diffuse shader and a little bit of glossy shader as well. And as usual, to control the wave texture, we will use the color ramp. So let's get started. So I already have the scene set up, and let's go to shading tab and click on new, and I will delete this principal BSDF and add in a mix shader, because I will be adding a diffuse and a glossy shader. So to combine those two, we will need a mix shader. And I will add in the diffuse shader in first one, and let's change the color to blue. So this will be the color of our fabric, and now increase the roughness, and I will add in a bump node, because all our threads are the bump in the fabric. And I will add in a glossy shader, connect it to the second shader, and connect the normal of the bump to the glossy shader, and I will decrease the factorial to somewhere around 0.1. And now let's add in the wave texture. So go to texture and click on wave texture, and click on Ctrl T to add in the mapping and texture coordinate. And I will add in a color ramp to control the value of the wave texture. And as we discussed, we have to add in two wave textures. So I will duplicate this and duplicate the mapping as well. And instead of general, I want the value to be object from the texture coordinate, and I will connect it to the vector of both of the mapping. And now to combine the values of the wave texture, I will add in a mix RGB node and connect the color to the color 1 and color 2 of both the wave textures, just like this. And I will connect the color to the factorial of the color ramp, and the color of the color ramp to the height for the bump in our fabric. So it will look something like this. And now all we have to do is the play with the values of the wave texture and color ramp. So I will increase the scale to 10. And increase the details. And now I will rotate the Y value to maybe 45 degrees. And minus 45 degree over here. So as you can see, both are kind of perpendicular to each other, which we want. And let's bring the values of this color ramp together so that we have a sharp bump in our fabric, something like this. And now I will change the type of the mapping to texture for both of the mappings. And increase the factorial. And change the mix to multiply. So this will multiply both of the wave textures. This is 4, so this should be minus 45. And now I will increase the scale to maybe 30 for both the textures. I will increase the roughness of the glossy a bit. And it will look something like this. And now in the rendered view, it will look something like this. So let's render it to get a sharp image of it. So after rendering, it will look something like this. And as you can see, we can see the thread lines in both X and Y axis, which worked out pretty well for the wave texture. And our cloth is looking much realistic. You can add in more color ramps and shader nodes in your node tree to give the extra effect for the cloth. But this is usually the node tree for a simple cloth. So I hope you learned something from this session, and I hope now you got the idea to how to proceed with a procedural texture. Let me know if you guys want to see the tutorial of any other procedural texture in Blender. I hope you guys enjoyed the procedural texture series tutorial in Blender. Thank you for watching the video. Make sure to subscribe the channel, and I will see you in the next one.